The 12 Lost Compositions of Dmitri Zarkov, a story narrated and authored by Maury Rosenberg. Accordionist and composer Dmitri Nikolai Zarkov lived a long life, yet his musical talent never reached critical acclaim until late in life. The recordings you're listening to are from his last concert at Royce Hall, which took place in the early 90s. He disappeared the day after the show and was never seen or heard from again. This is what we know of him. Dmitri Nikolai Zarkov was born in 1906 in the city of Bertolinovka, Russia, as the sixth child in a family of poor Jewish farmers. He was raised by his aunt Natalia, who introduced Dmitri to the violin at a very young age. He excelled quickly on the violin. Unfortunately, Dmitri had to make money for the family and began working in the brickyards. The side effect was his fingers became too muscular to continue on the violin. But on his 11th birthday, he received an accordion from his uncle Victor. This gift would change his life forever. Every day he practiced, though the world around him was quite volatile. He created a musical world inside his head which kept him at peace with his surroundings. In 1917, the Bolshevik uprising was responsible for the death of Dmitri's father Nikolai, as well as several of his relatives. During this time, Dmitri lived deep in the woods and was able to survive on wild animals and fishing. His musical prowess was gaining. He found himself on the run in order to avoid getting caught up in the ongoing conflict. He left in such a hurry he could only bring his accordion and a picture of his uncle Victor with him. He learned that living away from family and loved ones would be both difficult and challenging indeed. Traveling alone and without any true direction, Dmitri decided to head towards Petrograd in hopes of finding other musicians to both play and learn from. On his journey, for both room and board, he worked as a farmhand and also played accordion at wedding parties in various villages along the way. His eventual path to Petrograd brought him there just as it was renamed Leningrad in 1924. Now at the age of 18, Dmitri found himself in a big city without knowing anyone. On the outskirts of the city, he found people living in makeshift tents and discovered his new love of both the gypsies and their music. Dmitri's time spent with the gypsies came at a price. For the next 20 years, he would be drawn towards the darker side of life. Drinking and womanizing was just the beginning. He soon learned how to pick pockets and would steal food from the public markets in order to eat. After fooling around with another man's woman, his life was threatened, so he packed up what he had and left for Moscow. In Moscow, he befriended violinist Leonid Borisovich Kogan. When they played music together, it sounded like a dream. Reality would soon turn the dream into a nightmare. Moscow was alive with culture and Dmitri loved it. For for money, he taught accordion during the day. At night, vodka and more vodka. He drank himself into the local prison quite successfully. In jail, he met an old acquaintance who had bad news regarding Dmitri's family back home. During the war of 1920, all but a few of his relatives died. Composing music and reading the poetry of Nikolai Gumilyov was how he coped, even though fate would soon be on his side. Dmitri had an epiphany. Should he decide to stay in Moscow, he would be dead within a year. His plan was to leave Russia altogether and make his way to the New World, America. As fate would have it, upon being released from jail, he was able to stow away on a Russian cruise ship destined for Cuba. The seas were very rough, and he came very close to starvation. He drew his strength from the melodies in his head and his strong desire for a new life. While stowed away in the belly of the cruise ship, he would think of this melody over and over again. It brought him peace. Jumping ship in Cuba, Dmitri was able to find shelter, food, and support at the Soviet embassy. For several years, he worked doing menial jobs in exchange for very little money and Spanish lessons. He was enthralled with the musical sounds of Cuba. Salsa bands and Latin rhythms grew on him. Due to the changing political climate, he found work on a commercial fishing boat, which brought him to Puerto La Cruz, Venezuela. South America would expand his mind in ways he'd never imagined. Traveling through South America, Dmitri came in contact with many musicians playing different styles of music. He would soon translate these sounds into his compositions. Having made his way to Argentina, Dmitry rented a small room in a boarding house near Casco Historico. He was hired as a dishwasher at Café Tortoni, one of Buenos Aires' oldest cafes. While washing dishes, he would listen to live performances of the legendary tango artist, Astor Pantaleon Piazzolla. Dmitry was the happiest dishwasher in Buenos Aires. Upon happening into the cafe one day, Astor heard Dmitry play. Realizing Dmitry's accordion was all but worn out, Astor gave him an accordion. From time to time, Astor would feature Dmitry Zarkov performing a short set of compositions prior to his concerts. One night after performing, Dmitry fell in love with a tourist from California named Eleanor Ann Caswell. They would see each other for many years and finally decide to get married. At the wedding, a klezmer band played one of Dmitry's compositions, while the local Jewish Hasidic community danced a Yemenite step. It was breathtaking to watch. In 1972, Dmitry and Eleanor moved to the United States and lived in Los Angeles. The next 10 years would be filled with joy as Dmitry loved his wife Eleanor. He took on accordion students and worked nights as a security guard at Grumman's Chinese Theater in Hollywood for extra cash. Tragically, Eleanor lost her life in a car accident, which left Dmitry traumatized. He started drinking and soon after became homeless. Near death, he was taken in by one of his accordion students, Eric Kornhauser. Eric brought Dmitry to AA meetings and was able to rejuvenate him through constant encouragement. Dmitry was able to gain his musical vision back. Forming an ensemble, he performed a public concert at Royce Hall featuring 12 of his compositions. Zarkov's ensemble received standing ovations. After the concert, Dmitry was seen fighting with a stranger and appeared visibly shaken. Dmitry Nikolai Zarkov would never be seen again. Presently, the 12 lost compositions of Dmitry Zarkov can be accessed on the internet in connection with and under the care of Maury Rosenberg, the musical director of Hypnotic Clambake. All 12 compositions have been slightly enhanced orchestrally and then digitally remastered. They can now be downloaded at most audio music outlets online. Thank you for your interest in the life and music of Dmitry Nikolai Zarkov. Share his music with friends and hope that the 12 lost compositions of Dmitry Zarkov will sooner or later be found.